How should I back up my email? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com, where I've been backing up email and helping people to recover from lost email since 2003. Let's start with our question. I have many times deleted some of my important emails from my inbox. I was even locked out of my account when some hacker tried hacking my email. So I was looking for a backup solution that I can view my emails even when my email provider is down. Do you think that Drop My Email is the way to go? I do not want an offline backup since it's a pain to load them all the time in case I want to get my emails back. First off, awesome that you're backing up your email or even just considering backing up your email. So many people do not, and it really becomes a pain when, as happened to you apparently, a hacker comes along and steals your account, gets into your account where you can no longer gain access to your own account. They can delete everything, or if you never regain access, all of your email is gone. So backing it up is critical, without a doubt. Now, I do have a different opinion on exactly how you should go backing it up, but let's walk through some of the issues. There are two general approaches. One is to back up your email locally. That's kind of the solution that you didn't want. I prefer it, but we'll talk about that in a moment. The idea here is that to back up your email locally, you, on a PC, install an email program like Thunderbird or Microsoft Office's Outlook or any of a number of others, and configure it to download your email using the IMAP protocol. What that does is downloads email, but keeps everything in sync with what's online. It's the protocol we actually use very often these days to allow several different machines, including our mobile devices, to access the same email account from multiple different places and have changes made in one place show up in the other. It's perfect for this scenario because all you really need to do is fire up your email program on that PC, and once it's configured, just let it run. It magically keeps itself up to date with whatever's going on in your email as you process your email normally online or on other devices. The other approach is to do kind of sort of the same thing except online. For example, let's say you have your email with Outlook.com online. The approach here would be to create a different email account, say with Gmail, Google's mail service, but have that then configured to remotely fetch email from your Outlook.com account. In other words, the Gmail account kind of sort of acts like a desktop email program in that it fetches email the same way, but it's an online service. The catch here is that there is no IMAP support. Generally, what that means is you end up having to configure the remote email service to use POP3. What's critical is that you then configure that POP3 retrieval to quote-unquote leave messages on server. That way, the Gmail account is simply making a copy of all your email periodically as it finds it in your original Outlook.com account, without affecting the Outlook.com account. You continue to use your email normally at Outlook.com, but if you ever need to go back and fetch a backup copy or something from the past, you can go over to that Gmail account and access everything you need. Now, specifically with desktop email programs, I have to point out that the program has to be working. It has to be running. What that means is that, yes, you actually have to have Thunderbird running on a machine in order for Thunderbird to download and back up your email. Thunderbird or Microsoft Office, Outlook, or whatever email program you choose. As I record this on a machine, in fact, I think it's over in the corner back there, my laptop, it is in fact running Thunderbird right now. It's backing up email from several different accounts into a common Thunderbird scenario. So that is something that's worth realizing. With respect to online email services, the Gmail fetching from Outlook.com, in other words, Gmail acting as a backup for your Outlook.com, it's unclear. You're going to want to sign into the Gmail account periodically, at any rate, just to make sure you continue to have access and that it doesn't get shut down or something because of inactivity. I believe it'll continue to fetch all the time, whether you're logged in or not. Log in periodically anyway. Now, putting email back gets a little bit strange. It's something that you mentioned, and it's unfortunately easy in one case, the case you don't want, and not that easy in the other. If you're using a desktop email program and you're using IMAP to actually keep everything in sync, then putting email back is actually pretty straightforward. You simply copy it from one folder to another on your PC, that gets replicated back online, and you're done. It's all put back. When it comes to POP3, it gets really strange, really hard, and really not that easy. My solution, if I were forced into this kind of a scenario, would actually be to set up Google's Gmail, not only to fetch email from my Outlook.com account, but I would have it be able to send email as my Outlook.com account. So I could actually send and receive email from that account as if I were using Outlook.com directly. Putting things back into an Outlook.com account is going to be fairly difficult, fairly cumbersome, and honestly, probably involves setting up a PC using IMAP and copying emails back and forth as the most comprehensive solution to that kind of a problem. Now, there's one more thing I want to point out, and this is honestly one of the bigger reasons that I really prefer the download to a PC backup version, and that is that you're doubly protected. Because, of course, you are backing up your PC regularly, right? If you're not, do that. You need to start doing that right away. But the good news is that if you're using your PC to download your email as a backup, then when you back up your PC, you're also doubly backing up your email. That's a great way to keep things, well, extra safe and extra backed up. And in many cases, allows you to retain snapshots of your email from further back in time rather than just what you happen to have on the PC at that particular moment. My recommendation, honestly, is that you give serious consideration to using a PC or a Mac or whatever, a desktop PC, to download your email and back it up that way. That will give you the most flexibility and allows you to be more backed up, be more secure about losing, potentially losing email. If you want to do the online scenario, use any of a number of different online accounts to do that. I've used Gmail here as my example to back up your Outlook.com account, but essentially any service that provides the ability to fetch from another account using the POP3 protocol will work as a backup account as well. As I said when I started, good on you for considering this at all. Too many people don't. If you are one of those people who have not been backing up your email, please start. For links related to this article, for the article on which this video was originally based, for updates, comments, and more, visit askleo.com/5983. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is Ask Leo.